All right, so next up, we have Joshua. Joshua was born in Uganda. He serves in the United States Army and has lived in America for 5 years. He founded a charity called the Fallen Children of Uganda to help kids who are poor, living on the street, and orphan. He also raises fundraises to feed children attending 4 elementary schools in Uganda. Let's give it up for Joshua!
I have always asked myself 3 questions. One of it is Africa torn apart? Gods must be crazy? Or is life a choice? It all begins with money. Everybody of us need money. Money can make you have anything you want. It don't have to be in dollars, it could be in shillings or pounds or any kind of currency. Make you happy, right? Everybody need a part of that. I do. Yeah, money can make you have something like that. You can choose to sleep in an ocean, and a fish could be your neighbor because you got money. That's good. Or you can choose to sleep in a heaven with the angels like that. I like that. I wish I had money to buy that, but anyway, whatever. Well, things are about to change right now. Just a little bit. We're gonna go to the African side of it. Bam! That's right there. You could choose to sleep in the ocean or sleep in that neighborhood. That is the African way of life, right? That could be any one of us here. Could be you. That could be you. So, yeah, that's the African neighborhood right there. Or this girl right here. That is a city, like Dayton, Ohio. That is kind of a city in Uganda. That has a member of parliament. They have all the politicians you can think about. They live there. That is a city in Uganda. Bam! You got money, like my high school friend right there. You can buy a Bugatti like that and drive it by yourself. You don't have to carry nobody. I asked her to write with her, she said, right, whatever. Okay, mine someday. Bam! The African way, right there. She can drive herself and don't want to take me with her. Look, Africa, those are about 10, I don't know how many in the front, but they can share like that. It is not a choice. You gotta go or you gotta stay. Bam! That is one of my friends, he's 19 years. I wish I had that car when I was 19. I should have put girls in programs. Well, right? That's him. He's only 19 years. He drives himself. Right. Or you can drive the other one or the African way right here. If that van leaves you, you have to wait 3 days to go to the city. You have to get somewhere on that track to go to the city. Oh. America. When babies get only 60, every one of us needs a glass of water, cold water. Guess what? In Africa, temperatures go 100, 110, 120. Yeah. Guess what? There is no choice. This boy right here, either drink that water or die thirsty. Right? That is Africa. That's the African way. It's a point of no choice, I guess. Oh, gods must be crazy. Or Africa is torn apart. Well, or like that, 100 degrees, you burning, your throat is burning, you need something. You gotta drink that or die. Okay? Yeah, that's my sweet Africa. That's where I came from. I grew up in that neighborhood right there. Or, you see that? That is where I used to get water. in that pond right there. Sometimes the pond is dry, oh, there is so little water that you have to fight. You got survival for the fittest. I used to kick a lot of people in that pond, and they used to kick me if they are fitter than me. Yeah, we used to fight like that. Or, this is funny, you choose to wash your clothes in dirty water or don't wash at all. Washing in dirty water is almost not washing at all. The guy is trying to clean his clothes in dirty water. That is Africa. That's one of my favorites right there. In a relationship, we all look for happiness, right? Happiness in a relationship is not for all. Some people choose to do it the old African way of fashion. We are about to see. Guess what? These people. All right. Bam. This guy right here, he paid dowries for his wife. His wife became his property. It is okay in Africa. You can give your wife a few kicks, a few slaps. It is okay. She's your property. The African way of life. Yeah, she's getting some because breakfast was a few minutes late. Yeah, schools. Every one of us, you remember those days. You only love two things, your parents and your food, right? Those were your best friends, your parents and your food. Africa, look at the background. That is a school back there. And I think you can see me right there in the black jacket right there. That's me right there. That is a school in Africa, in my country, Uganda. Right. It's not so difficult to make a desperate person happy. I think that school has 300 children. I give them $400 a semester, which is 3 months, for food. That is what they write back to me. I paid four schools. One of the schools, they say, a word without you, our word without you is a useless word. Anyway, you can go to YouTube and find out Fatherly Children Uganda 2015. Or go to my website, www.fatherlychildrenuganda.org. Thank you.